Hello, my name is Viktor Kolobov, and today I'm going to talk to you about fast deterministic algorithms for highly dynamic networks. This is a joint work with Karen Sansovi-Lev, Neta Daphne, Abby Paz, and Gregory Schwarzman. And I hope you'll enjoy it. So in this work, we deal with distributed graph algorithms. So let's first recall the so-called static setting. So in this setting, we have a network of nodes, and the nodes wish to compute a function of their input and the network topology. So this can be, for example, a legal coloring of the graph, or maybe some sort of independent set. The network is modeled as a static graph, where edges correspond to bidirectional communication links between the nodes on which they can exchange messages. We assume that the network is synchronous, so it proceeds in rounds. And in this model, this is the main complexity measure. So if you have an algorithm which computes some tasks, so you will first look at how many rounds it took for the nodes to compute their output. In particular, we usually ignore the local computation that the nodes perform, although for our algorithms and for many other in the literature, this is not a problem. Messages can be either unbounded in size, this is the so-called local model, or just restricted to overflowing bits, and this is known as the congest model. In our work, we'll also focus on overflowing bit messages. So in this work, we study a highly dynamic setting where undoubtedly many topology changes may occur per round. This can be seen as an opposite extreme to the static setting that is congest, where the network remains completely static. And an additional motivation for us, as opposed to just, in addition to just studying this model for its own sake, is that we think it's a necessary step towards studying more intricate dynamic settings. For example, in real-world networks, maybe the changes are not so frequent, but maybe it's also unrealistic to assume that the network is completely static. So by looking at what's possible for the highly dynamic setting where the adversary is very powerful, it would make it easier to study more realistic dynamic settings. So while working in a dynamic setting, one hope is to fix solution faster than computing them from scratch. This is also applicable in the distributed setting, where suppose we have some graph and we compute some solution. Now we introduce a change in the graph, and now we want to fix the solution faster than computing it from scratch by applying a congest algorithm. So in some distributed dynamic settings, this may be possible, although in our highly dynamic setting, congest algorithms are usually inapplicable because the network topology may change every round. The highly dynamic setting is also in stark contrast to the centralized dynamic setting. In the centralized setting, all the computation happens on one computer. So suppose your input is some graph and it experiences some topology changes, then you can deal with those changes incrementally and always maintain a global solution. So, because we work in the distributed setting, this is more problematic because changes also affect communication. So, if an edge is deleted from the network, then the nodes, which were the endpoints of this edge, can no longer communicate on it. Thus, obtaining a global solution is hopeless, unless, of course, your algorithm finishes in zero rounds. Hence, we need to be more careful when we refer to notions such as fixed net solution. And indeed, because finding a global solution is impossible most of the time, we try to look at tasks which have some notion of a local solution. And In this work, we focus on locally checkable labeling, so LCLs for short. So this notion was introduced by Norman Stockmayer in 95. And roughly speaking, we say that labeling is an LCL if its validity can be checked by all the nodes locally. So if all of them agree on the consistency of the labeling, then this labeling is correct globally. And if the labeling is not correct, if one node does not agree, then this labeling is not correct. So as an example of LCL, you can consider maximal matching. So in this drawing, the red edges correspond to the matched edges. And you can see that in this graph, we indeed have a maximal matching. Now, if we look at the local view of each node, we can be convinced that it is indeed a maximal matching. So all nodes will be convinced, and thus it is indeed a correct maximal matching. For example, it's also easy to see that if the matching was not maximal, then at least one of the nodes would detect this, because it would be unmatched and it would have an unmatched neighbor. So in similar fashion, we would like to see whether we can locally fix an LCL, and by that we mean that there are some topology changes occurring in the network, and we would like to fix the labeling by only looking at the labeling of a node and its neighbors and apply the relevant correction only to that neighborhood. And thus the question becomes whether we can always locally fix an LCL. And while we're at that, we also want to do that with a reasonable round complexity. So consider, as it turns out, the answer to the question is no. So consider the LCL by the name of almost endless orientation. This just requires an orientation of the edges such that all sinks have degree one. And by sinks, I mean nodes which don't have outgoing edges according to the orientation of the edges. So you can easily be convinced that this is indeed an LCL. And for example, you can see in this graph that the middle node can locally check the consistency of the edges that it sees. So suppose we have an additional graph component like so, and also assume that they are linear in the number of nodes. Now suppose that we connect them by an edge like so. So this is just a single topology change, but it requires all the edges on the in the right component to change their orientation. So surely this LCL cannot be fixed locally, because a single topology change requires the edges which are far away to change the orientation. Now suppose we delete this edge and we add an additional edge from the other side. Now, not only are we convinced that this LCL cannot be locally fixed, also it cannot be fixed with a reasonable amortized round complexity. Thus, the answer to this question is no. So the next question becomes, when can we locally fix an LCL? And more broadly, what problems can be locally fixed? So variants of this question were studied in the literature, and I'll give a partial survey. So Koenig and Vattenhofer in 2013 showed how to fix various problems in a single round using large messages. Also, Cesar Hillel, Aramati and Kranin showed in 2016 that MIS can be fixed in all fun rounds using the small messages, and their algorithm is randomized. Then there is the line of work of Asadi, Onak, Shiber and Solomon from 18 and 19, Du and Zheng from 18, and Gupta Khan from 18. They studied a centralized setting, but as a byproduct, they obtained in a distributed setting a way to fix MIS in all of one amortized rounds using small messages. and their algorithm is deterministic. This can be seen as an improvement to the work of Tsenzo Villela, Ramati and Pernin. By virtue of the algorithm being deterministic, we no longer need to assume an oblivious adversary which is not aware of the randomness of the nodes. Also, Solomon in 2016 showed how to fix matching in all four unadvertised rounds. And part of Peleg Solomon in 2016 showed how to fix various tasks in all Flockstar and unadvertised rounds. Now, what's common between all these works is that they assume that only a single topology change occurs at a time. So the way that it works is that you have some graph and you compute some solution. Now, a single topology change occurs. The algorithm is given time to stabilize, and only then a new topology change will occur. And in this work, we study a highly dynamic setting. And actually, the only work we are aware of, the only previous work we are aware of, which also deals with the highly dynamic setting, is the work of Bamberg and Kuhn and Maus from 18, who show how to fix various covering and packing tasks with worst case O of log n round complexity using polylog n bit messages, and the algorithms are randomized. Also, we have a subsequent work in this model where we study listing subgraphs. So now moving to our results, we obtain algorithms which are deterministic, have O of one amortized running time, and use only O of log n bit messages. If you consider either edge or node insertions and deletions as a single topology change, then our amortization can be shown to work for either maximal matching, delta plus one coloring, or MIS. With the caveat that for MIS, we need to start from an empty graph for the amortization to work, and for all other problems you consider, you can start from some graph and any valid solution. If you no longer consider node deletion as a single topology change, then we can also deal with two approximation of minimum weight vertex cover. And if you only consider edge insertion and deletions as a single topology change, then we can also deal with degree plus one cover. So we have obtained algorithms for various important tasks, although our algorithmic framework can be shown to extend to other locally fixable labelings, and if you're interested in the full version of the paper, we give a somewhat complicated combinatorial parameterization of what labelings we can locally fix, although this is just a sufficient condition and this is in no way exhaustive. Our algorithms also have an intermediate solution guarantee. And by that we mean that if the labeling L of some neighborhood NV is fixed by the algorithm, then this labeling will remain correct unless new topology change occur, topology changes occur for nodes in the neighborhood. We also obtain O of N worst case running time, and by that we mean there is no starvation. So if the labeling of some neighborhood becomes dirty and it's pending to be fixed, and also no new changes occur for this neighborhood, then it will take at most O of N rounds for this particular neighborhood to get its labeling fixed. And we believe that this can be improved maybe along the lines of the work of Bamberger, Kuhn and Maus, which obtained O of log n worst case complexity. So now I'll give an outline of our algorithm. So our algorithm is chopped into epochs of five rounds. And we maintain an invariant that at the end of epoch I, which is round 5i plus 4, nodes which were fixed by the algorithm are correct. Their labeling is correct with respect to the graph topology at the start of epoch I, so around 5i. And the way we achieve that is via two-stage fixing. So first, when a topology change occurs at a node, then this node reverts to a default label, and at the start of the epoch, it sends this label to its neighbors. The actual fix happens in the end of an epoch, where a node gets the label of itself and maybe its neighbors fixed. Of course, if a topology change occurred during the epoch for nodes which were designated for a fix, then they just abort. This does not hurt the amortization because we can account for the additional delay by the batch we get from the new topology change, which caused a node to abort. We also require that fixed nodes must be at least 4 hops apart for consistency. And we obtain this by using free rounds of an epoch to propagate timestamps. Now, timestamps may be unbounded in size, but we remedy this by hashing them into O of log n bits using a technique by Atiya Dolev-Shavit from 1989. Next, I would like to give you an illustration of our algorithm on the problem of maximum matching. So suppose we have a graph like so, and the red edges correspond to the maximal matching. And suppose that we delete edges U5W and VU4. So in round zero, relevant nodes revert to the default label, which in the case of maximal matching is just being unmatched. Also, the red circles over the nodes represent that these nodes are dirty and they haven't yet obtained a final correction, which occurs at the end of an epoch. So now, in rounds 1 to 3, timestamps are propagated. So U and V have unmatched neighbors. So one of them should be matched to U3. And U4 and U5 don't have unmatched neighbors. Now assume that V wins, and in its free hop neighborhood, it has the minimal timestamp. So only this node gets fixed. So U4 and W remain dirty. Also U5 gets fixed because it has the minimal timestamp in its free hop neighborhood. Then in round 5, there are no new topology changes. In round 6 to 8, again, timestamps are being propagated. But suppose that in round 9, a new topology change occurs. So the edge WU3 gets deleted. So W aborts. But U4 still gets fixed. And as you can see, if no new, so this does not hurt the amortization because we pay for the delay by the new topology change. And if no new topology changes occur for the dirty nodes, then eventually we will converge to a legal maximal matching. As another note, here we maintain the fact that nodes which are designated to be fixed are at least 4 hops apart, but specifically for maximal matching, you could make do with just 3 hops. So finally, I would like to briefly discuss the algorithm we have for maximal independent set, which is the most intricate case that we study. So suppose that we have a maximal independent set as in the drawing, where the red nodes correspond to nodes in the MIS. Now suppose we connect these two nodes via an edge. So now one node needs to leave the MIS. And as you can see, by applying a naive amortization, we will no longer get O of 1 round complexity, because now many nodes may enter the MIS. So indeed, if one would want to mark all neighbors of a node as dirty, then this would violate the unmutized complexity, which we want. So the route we take instead is for the fixed node to indicate to neighbors, to some neighbors, to become dirty. So the amortization idea here comes into play the fact that we start from an empty graph. So if we start from an empty graph, then all nodes start in the MIS. So now observe that if a node re-enters the MIS, that means it's sometime it left the MIS and then it entered it again, then this can be blamed on a topology change which caused it to leave the MIS in the first place. And this ties to the complexity of the naive, greedy, distributed MIS algorithm in the static setting, where you just add at least one node to the MIS every round. And the running time of this greedy algorithm is just linear in the size of the MIS. So it may be much smaller than n, where n is the number of nodes. So this is the main idea there. In summary, in this work we obtain deterministic algorithms in a highly dynamic setting with O of 1 amortized running time using O of log n bit messages. We think that our work raises many interesting questions. For example, what other additional tasks can we locally fix? Whether we can deal with tasks of larger radius, so in this work we only consider tasks of radius 1. Whether we can improve the worst case complexity, and of course, maybe we can also consider other dynamic settings. So, thank you.